babies. How are you?
I'm well. I'm fine. Thank you so much, Patty, for allowing us to be on the call.
We're going to start with you, Anne. Tell us the importance of why this alliance came together.
A lot of us are business owners, and that's how we was able to start working together. Because so many of us was in a state of emergency when we were forced to shut down. And it forced us to learn what was going on in our city and our state.
Bertina, what do you hope that people get out of this as you gather up more stylists and, you know, owners of businesses and barbers?
The most important thing I hope that we get is building sustainability for our businesses, whether it's the structure of the business, financial support, building community around our black and brown businesses, especially because we're one of the longest standing industries that remain in our neighborhood. So the biggest thing is that we gain a sense of stability, morally, business-wise, and financially.
This is really good because the pandemic has really turned things upside down. And was it hard getting groups to participate or seeing, like, you guys need to be a part of this?
Yeah, so I've worked with a lot of barbers and licensed cosmetologists throughout my career. And so it was very easy for me to reach out to my friends. And because all of us have other friends and family in the industry, we were all able to band together. And I think it was the integrity part that allowed so many people to join so fast. A lot of us did not get the right information in the very beginning. So when we started collaborating with one another, we started realizing that, hey, this is the struggle for all of us. So a lot of us put our pride and ego away because a lot of times we have a bad reputation in Philadelphia that we don't know how to work together. And that's really untrue. So the reason why we got on this call today is to express to people the concern about the grant. You know, we have less than 2 weeks before the final rollout comes out. And what I mean by that is this grant has allowed us as black and brown businesses to receive funding. And if we do not look at our emails or our text information in reference to the industry, then you might not be able to receive this grant. So the purpose of this call today is to really share with our business owners that listen to you, Patty, the importance of paying attention to your emails, because a lot of us have fought for this grant, and this is why it came to Pennsylvania. So, thank you. I can't thank you enough for allowing us to have this platform, because it was our advocacy that brought all of us together and our love for our city.
Bertina, how can they find out more, you know, about the grant, how, you know, you got to use it, got to be prepared for 2021?
Exactly. Totally got to be prepared for 2021. So, first, the grant, let's be very clear. I want to make sure that the listeners understand what we're saying with the grant. The PA CARES Relief Fund that was released to small businesses back in June and August is the grant that we are mentioning. That grant has been closed since the beginning of September, but people who applied for it back in June and August are still being evaluated and or awarded. So the most important factor with this particular grant is that the funds have to be spent by December 30th. What this means is that you have to reply and respond to any correspondence that comes through so that you're either find out that you're eligible or put in the proper paperwork that will continue the process so that you will receive your fund. If this money is not spent by December 30th, it goes back to the state and federal government. And what that means is that it really looks like we might not need the funds, when in fact we really, really need these funds. So first part, the grant already exists. Please pay attention to all of your email and text messages. Second part is that our organization, along with others, we want to advocate for future funding. There was a bill that was recently proposed to the local, our state and federal government for $4 billion. Some of you might be familiar with this. It was produced by our elected officials in the Philadelphia area. And what it means is that $800 million of those dollars is outlined to be allocated to our small businesses. If we stand behind our elected officials and help to push this charge for getting this funding, we could have an opportunity to actually be able to get more funding for 2021. But we have to be very, very diligent in what we do with this current grant that exists.
And how can, they find out more about the grant?
So the grant that is coming up for that's on the table table. You guys can go to Senator Hughes' website to kind of look into information about that. And then the grant that is existing now, which is the PA CARES Relief Grant, again, it's not open, but in order to get your paperwork through, you just need to, you know, you apply for it, so just check your email to see if you qualify. You can reach us on social media at PA Professional and the Lions on Facebook as well as Instagram. We will be making posts and keeping things updated through the social media because we know that's how people like to communicate. And then you can also email us at 10proia@gmail.com.
And Turner, for Tina Pelzer, the Pennsylvania Professional Image Alliance, thank you so much for the great information. Thank you.
Thank you, Patty. Have a beautiful day.
Let's return to the